Okay, so this will be a probably a medium length video. Okay, medium length. So firstly, I'll go first with the props. Well, I'll explain first the props. Okay, first the props. Props, okay. Props. Okay, props here. Props, okay. And then another prop. Okay, prop. Okay. Props, okay. This covers the needle, okay. My prop is a. Hypodermic needle, hypodermic needle, okay? But I discover there's a brand name. I discovered a brand name. This is actually a ball pen. It looks like a syringe, okay? Syringe, 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 okay? Syringe. Actually, it's a ball pen. Okay? So, having said that, I discover cover. Okay, cover. Okay, cover. So, that's the back part. Back part. Here is the front part. Okay? Front part, back part, it's now a syringe. Okay? It's now a syringe. Okay? Syringe. My topic is I saw on television a person mixing up, here's the topic, a person mixing up a solution. It's not pure water, not pure water. Mixing up with the solution, and after mixing up the liquid solution, putting the liquid solution here. Okay, liquid solution here. And then injecting here inside the nose, the water got coming out here. Okay, and another filled up with the solution the person made. Okay, solution the person made, putting it here and injecting. So pressure, water comes out here. Okay, water from the syringe comes out to the other side. Water comes out here. Okay? So that's the story. That's the whole topic of the video. Okay? So the person saw this as a solution to allergic rhinitis. Okay? So what's wrong there? Okay? What's wrong there? Firstly, that is not a medical solution. Okay? Making a liquid solution and then pushing it up here. Water coming out here. Pushing it out, pushing the water here and water coming out on the other side. Okay? That's not a medical solution. Now, for one thing, if the water is not clean enough, the nasal turbinates will be infected. Also, if the solution is not in quotation mark solution enough, not solution enough, not dissolved enough, precipitates may may accumulate in the nasal turbinates. Oh, by the way, the anatomic part water mixed compound. Water mixed compound going here, water mixed compound going here and going out on the other side. Okay? I'll say this first in Tagalog, igagal nyo na lang ang correlational anatomy. Igagal nyo na lang ang correlational anatomy. Suffice today na pag sinabi kong increase speed, pwede magkaroon ng bacteria. Okay? Kung yung water eh, hindi na magano kalinis. Okay? Okay? Did you get that? Igagal nyo na lang ang correlational anatomy. Correlation. Anatomical correlation. Okay? I'll not show here anatomy. this is a video for laymen. Okay? For everybody. Not for experts. Okay? This is not a medical lecture. Okay, so you just have to look at the where's the nasal turbinates? You have to Google it. Okay? So precipitates may fall on that if it's not dissolved enough. So that's one thing. Bacteria may accumulate, infection may accumulate in the nasal turbinates. So that's the second. The third one, somewhere along the inside, are many holes. too many to specify. Okay? Now, if you put pressure here, inside here, and inside here, water comes in through pressure, with pressure, it may go inside the openings for the sinuses. Okay, there are many sinuses there. And the water that you inject may accumulate in those openings. Okay, many openings. Since water accumulated in those openings, the mixture may also block those passages and or precipitate in those areas. If you do it frequently enough, you may develop precipitates inside those sinuses via those openings. Okay? That's the third one. That's the third one, don't do. Oh, by the way, things like this are given to doctors. I don't have a syringe here in the house. And things like this are given to doctors. Writing material. Okay? So, it's a fun part. It's actually a writing material. It's actually a ballpen. Okay? So, luckily I kept one of those. Okay? Given by med reps. So, you can have a writing material. It's cute. Cute writing material. Now, so those are, if I'm not mistaken, I have already said three. Okay? Three reasons not to do those things. The fourth one, I'll just read. If there is increased, increased pressure, water and humidity may accumulate there. Okay? You do it every day. Water and humidity may accumulate there. Increased humidity may increase the possibility of fungal infections. So that's the fourth reason. Increased possibility of fungal infections in the nasal turbinates and in the other sinuses. Okay? And the other sinuses. Number five reasons. There's also such thing as a protective covering, protective layer. Okay? Hard to explain. So, if I'm not mistaken, that's the sixth reason. If I'm not mistaken, sixth reason. I haven't put numbers here. So, in theory, you may take out the protective, in quotation mark, the protective covering layer, in quotation marks, and make the mucous area and things below that prone to infection because you took out the covering layer, protective layer. Covering layer, protective layer. Because of constant pressure. Okay, I hope you can imagine that. There's a protective layer, constant pressure here through water and the compound that you made. Okay, washing this all out. And so there will be no protective layer. Under that layer is fully exposed and infection and fungal infection may break out there. So that's the sixth reason not to do those things. Allergic rhinitis is a terribly easy thing to treat. Okay? It's there with you forever, allergic rhinitis. It's there with you forever. There's no cure. But for the symptoms, it's easy to be recommended medications for those symptoms. Okay? It's easy to deal with those symptoms. If you need medications, then there are lots of them. Okay? No need to do those putting water here under pressure and water coming out, and putting water here under pressure and water coming out. No need to do those things. For the six reasons that I demonstrated. Okay? So, that's it. Subscribe and follow. Follow and subscribe.